Hey guys, this is Conger at A Studio. Today I'm so excited to walk you through A Studio 2, the all-in-one AI music studio that keeps musicians ahead in the AI era. A Studio 2 now has four kinds of tools: vocal synth, AI instruments, generative kits, and audio editing tools including stem splitter, voice changer, and vocal to MIDI. With so many tools integrated, we redesigned our interface as a canvas, where all tools can be found in the toolbar at the bottom. So let's take a look. On the left part of the toolbar, you can find the vocal synth library and the AI instrument library. Click on the vocal synth icon, then you can browse a library with over 140 voices. Drop a voice onto the canvas to create a MIDI clip while inserting this voice on the track. You can also double-click on the canvas, select Generate Vocal from MIDI, and choose a voice to do the same. Once you got a MIDI clip, double-click on the body to open the piano roll. Then you can create your MIDI notes and type in lyrics. Back to the vocal synth library. In the tape bar, Pre-Made contains all voices made by Ace or partners. Cloned contains all your cloned voices and from others that share with you privately. You can click here to start your voice cloning. Community contains all voices published by users. Blended contains all saved blended voices under your account. Choir contains all choir presets both from Ace and your saved ones. If you want a kids choir, just drag this preset onto the canvas, then write your melody. At the right top corner, there is a switch between V2 and V1. It's the modal version of vocal synth. Voices from V2 are trained with our latest vocal synth model. It's super fast, powered by turbo mode, very expressive, and available in 8 languages. Voices from V1 are trained with our previous models. 4 languages, a little bit slower at rendering, but very stable. Now let's check out the instruments. Click on this icon to open the instrument library, where you can find all our pre-made instruments organized by strings, brass, and woodwinds. Drag an instrument onto the canvas just like an AI voice. There is also a tape contains ensemble presets. If you want some string sections, just drag them onto the canvas and compose. Alright, let's move on to the generative kits. The first feature is Music Enhancer. This AI tool can make your idea or demo into a production level track, which gives you more materials for further production. Let's create a new enhancement. Now it's telling you to select a region that you would like to enhance. Click Continue. Now it's analyzing lyrics and text of your select content. Every region you import from Canvas is under a session. You can find the session list on the left. When you see the analyzed lyrics and styles, you can edit it, then click Enhance to generate the result. It will give you two options to choose from. Drag the one you like onto the canvas as an audio clip. The second feature is Add a Layer. This AI tool can generate a layer based on your selection and can match your existing arrangement. Create a region where you like to add something. Then click on this icon to see the dialog. You can add a full instrumental track or just a stem like drums or guitar. Describe the layer you want, then click Generate. The third feature of generative kits is Inspire Me. It is basically a text-to-music AI but designed to provide tracks as ideas to help you get started. This feature can be found in the More Tools menu. In the dialog, you can just type in your ideas and click Generate. Each generation gives you two options to choose from, and you can drag the result onto the canvas as an audio clip. Now let's jump into audio editing AI tools. Stem splitter and voice changer can be found in the right-click menu on any audio clips, and also from the More Tools menu in the toolbar. To use a voice changer, select the region of the original vocal, then activate the voice changer dialog. You can select multiple voices at once, and setting up the pitch shift and time offset for each voice, so you can create harmonies or choir on one single vocal effortlessly. The voice changer also supports voice cloning. Just click on the clone the tape and you can get access to the cloning platform. The vocal to MIDI feature can be found in the right-click menu on any audio clips. It is also upgraded to V2, which provides more reasonable lyrics result with new languages supported. Okay, let's walk through some basics that you need to know about the new interface. Put your cursor on the trackhead. This is solo. This is mute. This opens the effects panel. Click on the icon of a voice or instrument to open the track dialog, where you can change the voice or instrument by clicking on this icon. Change the model version here. Activate choir mode for vocals or ensemble mode for instruments. And arrange the voice blending down here. At the left top corner of the main window, you can open the mixer here, or the tempo track or signature track, and also the chord track. A studio tool now supports tempo automation. We've provided a detailed wiki doc which you can get access from here. Alright, that's all. Hope you can get started with a studio tool. If you want to learn something specific, let me know in the comment. See you in the next video. Welcome to a studio.